See if it's going to come out right.
On the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above. On the wings of a dove, when troubles surround us, when evil comes, the body grows weak, and the spirit grows numb. When these things beset us, he doesn't forget us. He sends down his love on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove. He sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. When Noah had drifted so many days, he searched for land in various ways. Rebels he had some, but he wasn't forgotten, 'cause God sent down his love. Tell me now. On the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow-white dove, he sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow-white dove, he sends his pure sweet love, a sign from above, on the wings of a dove. On the wings of a dove, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a dove, on the wings of a dove.
All right. Thank you.
I think we've got a special, don't we? With the kids? Cashlin. All right. Cashlin's going to sing a song, and then we got the youth is going to come up here. Okay, she's not. They'll just keep me straight, won't they?
You know, I know there's some churches that just freak out about that because it didn't go by plan. Glory to God, it doesn't. Let the Lord take control of this thing, not us. What's that song, Chris? Steal My Show? Pray about that kid. I heard Austin Kent sing.
Just because Chris has heard me driving down the road in the truck, yep. Singing doesn't mean I.
reason to retreat. I got some dreams that are bigger than me. I might be outmatched, outsized, the underdog in the fight of my life. Is this so crazy to believe?
Okay, well, I guess we're fixing to start. The Easter play that we're doing is why we call him Savior. It says, this cross is a symbol of how much God loved us. And in John 3:16 we read, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life."
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. So despised by the world as wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. In the old rugged cross stained with blood so divine, a wondrous beauty I see. For 'twas there, that old cross, Jesus suffered and died to pardon and sanctify me. So I'll cherish the old till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true. Its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away with his glory forever I'll share. Trophies at last I lay
As we look at this crown of thorns and the purple robe, we're reminded of how Jesus suffered for us. John 19:2 tells us the soldier plaited a crown of thorns and placed it on Jesus' head. They mocked him, saying, "If thou be the King of Jews, save thyself." Let these nails remind us of the redeeming blood that was shed for you and for me.
With breath that brings the dead to life, with words that pierce child of God, lift your eyes to see. With every morning light, again we are redeemed. Rejoice, O child.
Legend that the cross is made of wood of a dogwood tree, and that it was cursed never to grow large again. And if you look at the center of the blossom, it resembles a cross. The legend goes, in Jesus' time, the dogwood grew to a stately size and a lovely hue. It was strong and firm, and its branches interwoven, and for the cross of Christ, its timbers were chosen. See the distress at this use of their wood. Christ made a promise which still holds. Never again shall the dogwood grow large enough to be used so, slender, twisted, and shall be with blossoms like the cross for all to see. As the blood stains of the petals marked in brown, the blossom centers wear a thorny crown. All who see it remember me, crucified on the cross of the dogwood tree, cherished and protected, this tree shall be a reminder to all of my agony.
His praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. The word became flesh and the light shined among us, his glory revealed. Living, he loved me. Dying, he saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he justified freely forever. One day he's coming. Oh, glorious day. Oh, glorious day.
As we look at the beauty of the lily, we are reminded of the suffering and the shame Jesus endured for us, but that he arose victorious over death, and by accepting Jesus as your Savior, so can we.
Amen.
Amen. Good job.
Hallelujah. Thank you. He is risen. Do you want to sing a song? Yes, ma'am. You may sing.
Jesus for the cleansing power. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Side. Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Do you rest each moment in the crucified? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? In the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood?
Washed in the blood of the Lamb.
There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Oh, be washed in the blood.